every teacher has their go-to move. And so with me being a math teacher, unfortunately, many kids come to my classroom and they say, I hate math, which I think is terrible that a student in middle school would have the idea or have the mindset that they hate mathematics. That is a reflection of a negative experience in the lower grade levels. But what I always do is I ask them a question. I say, hey, do you like money? And of course, most of them say, yeah, I like money. I want to make a lot of money. Well, I always tell them, if no other reason, you need to know mathematics so that you can keep track of this money that you're getting ready to make. And so some of them, there's always one kid who wants to be sarcastic and they'll say, well, I'm going to hire an accountant. And I always tell them, if you don't know mathematics, you'll never know if your accountant is stealing your money or poorly managing your money and things like that. So one of the things that has helped me be successful is I try to relate mathematics to numery ideas as much as I can. Since people like money, if you relate a mathematical topic to money or somehow relate it to how it can help them make money, I guarantee you kids will start to have more interest. So teachers, what is your go-to move? What is it that you do that always seems to work to help get across the message of the content that you're teaching? If you don't know your go-to move, do some reflection. Think about the things that have worked for you over the years and what are those things that work. If you don't have a go-to move, start trying things and eventually you'll see there's going to be that one thing that's your go-to move that tends to work every time when you're trying to get across one of those pieces of content or one of those topics that's not too popular. Remember, teachers change lives every day.